all. I was excited to get this footage. This is such a fun ride. Tight turns and brush line. Limited vision forces you to speed up your thinking process. However, this is not a closed course, so you have to be on full alert for a dust cloud or colors of an approaching vehicle or animal. I'm not sure I would even attempt this ride at any high speed if there were horse trailers present. And when I saw the footage, you can't tell how fast I was actually going. The footage doesn't do it justice. Regardless, it's a crazy fun ride. Ultimately, my sport has its drawbacks. It may not be great for those cinder climbs you might see on YouTube. It may never keep up in the open desert or dunes. You must have turns. The sport needs rutted, washed out roads with narrow lines. Since I'm a trail rider, I love it. The sport has taken my abuse. The sport has gotten me to all the places I would ask of it with low maintenance. It doesn't matter what you ride, really. If it makes you smile, if you have that moment of worry followed by the excitement you made it, if you feel the adrenaline of quick thinking and reaction, if your friends just give you a high five for an awesome ride, then love for that machine is all you can have. I have tried several communication platforms. Originally, we used radios that you can buy without a license with some success, except for when someone goes off the radar. You are lucky if you get 1 mile out of those radios. We then switched to bike helmet radios, the Bluetooth kind, which worked okay, but everyone needs a helmet, and when it's hot, it's hard to get everyone on board. Even then, 1 mile at best, and you get no signal behind a blocked corner. I often ride alone. I do things last minute, and that isn't good for coordinating a ride with someone else. Many places have zero phone coverage or spotty coverage. It was time to pass my ham license. The world of communication has been overwhelming. I can reach across a state, across the country, or across the world. I can patch into the phone network, share GPS coordinates, record tracks, create my own networks, on and on. From a survival point of view, ham radio is a lifesaver. The investment in testing is so small compared to the gain. We had a lost rider this weekend. With the ham radio, I was able to reach the rider and get it back to the meeting point. We got back to the base where my wife was waiting, and she mentioned that somebody got lost. The base was 2 miles in a straight line, blocked by a canyon wall due to a curve in the creek. She told me the transmission was perfectly clear. She heard the whole conversation. I had set up the radios to listen on a simplex frequency. It was a great example how ham radio has changed the game for us.
rejoin you, dear.
Goes in the school bus.